This video is sponsored by WingFox.
Digital artists shouldn't worry about AI. Big companies should. Many of you guys made very depressing comments under my latest video where I was trying out this website called ArtBreeder that uses AI to combine different pieces of art to create new ones. The comment section was filled with statements like "end my art career already" and stuff like that, and it seems like a pretty common fear right now among many digital artists that all of us will be pretty much replaced with AI soon enough. Now, while I think it's true that we're definitely not gonna have the same job and the same world we live in like 10, maybe 15 years from now, when AI will truly, you know, meet its potential, but I don't think that we're the ones that are gonna have a lot of problems with it. And of course, many aspects of this future are completely unknown. That's kind of the main thing about AI, that it really grows in unexpected ways sometimes. Many things become possible that you couldn't even imagine that that's what it's gonna do. But I think whatever happens in the future, one thing I can be pretty confident in is that real artists will only thrive in the age of AI, while big companies that develop movies, games, and all kinds of expensive-to-create media, they will either simply disappear, or they'll have to come up with a new type of media that will build upon whatever AI makes so easy to do. Now, why do I think that, and what the hell do I mean under real artists? Real artists are the ones that actually create new ideas, like actually new ideas. The chase of who makes the art the most realistic and expressive, you know, the basic stuff that you're supposed to know when you come out of the art school, that chase may be over pretty soon. Because good shape design, good colors, good anatomy, composition, any kind of stuff like that can turn into simple sliders, like how much of what you want, and that's all it is. Any kind of things that you have to learn with repetition and apply to every single piece of art you create, that will be gone. That's what AI is best at. It removes the necessity of repeating things, ever. That's why it's pretty hard to imagine what the world will be in the future, because even with a whole lot of innovations and, you know, things made much faster and automatic, pretty much all we do every day is still a whole lot of repetition. All the jobs, all the chores we do every day, everything is repeating basic stuff. Someone has to do it, so you just go ahead and do it. And it's even hard to imagine what the life would be if we would have like zero things to repeat. Anything you repeat, you're pretty much like, why aren't you using AI for that? The whole life will be completely transformed. But while in many aspects of this world, being able to use AI to remove those repetitions and have this sophisticated artificial assistant that would be able to do whatever it's familiar with for you, even in terms of, you know, creating a new kind of face, because it's familiar with hundreds and hundreds of thousands of faces it's seen before, and the same goes for the characters, for a game or a movie, that kind of stuff can be easily created, so pretty much the whole process of creation becomes kind of verbal. Instead of actually putting a brush to the canvas, you know, just talk to Photoshop or something like that. But the reason I think this is not a problem is because real art is actually exactly not about repetition. The true capital A artists are the ones that create something that has never been done before. And I'm not just talking about creating a new painting that, you know, can't be copyright claimed or something like that. I talk about a new kind of image that no one could even think of that you can make images that way. So in that perspective, using AI to create an image that, you know, looks exactly the way Picasso was making his paintings is absolutely useless. It has zero value. Same as if that kind of art would be created today by a human artist. It would never become valuable at all. The first thing anyone would say is just, well, you're just copying Picasso, who cares? And that's where we have a very interesting situation with big companies. because they produce a product like a movie or a high-budget, huge video game that usually you would think it has a whole lot of artists working on it, and that's why the product is so good. Well, not exactly. Now, my first language is Russian, and in Russian we have a bit of a more obvious distinction between art and craft. Well, obviously there are two words for that in English, but only when I started communicating in the English internet, I noticed that everyone is an artist. And whatever you draw or paint, you guys usually call it art. And if I would directly translate that to Russian, it would sound like you imply that any piece that you created is supposed to hang in a gallery. So what I'm trying to say is, there's just a very few artists out there, and most of us are actually craftsmen. And the difference between the two is the same as the difference between a scientist and an engineer. The scientist comes up with new things, and the engineer comes up with what to do with the things that the scientist already discovered. In a nutshell. And while it still kind of sounds depressing to have this view on things, and it sounds like I'm removing the value of so many artists in the industry, I don't think it's a bad thing, and I don't think that people that are more like craftsmen today, that they're doomed to not have a job at all. And speaking of today's craftsmanship, while AI is pretty far away from taking away our 3D jobs, this video sponsor WingFox has a new course called Environment Concept Design in Blender 2.91 and Photoshop. Your lecturer is Ivan Ilko, who's Ukrainian, just like me, by the way, and he's an art director as well as a co-founder of an indie game development studio. And he will share with you how to create a beautiful environment concept design by using the most out of Blender and Photoshop. You'll be working smart instead of working hard. You'll be creating your own kits of materials and models, as well as using particle systems to introduce beautiful variety to the scene with procedural scattering. You will learn how to work with lighting and composition, as well as how to properly embed images that will fit into your renders. But the process doesn't stop there, you will also be doing overpainting to achieve a painterly or artistic look, as well as add extra details without breaking the coherent look of the image. And with post-processing and color corrections, you will unify and blend in all adjustments and separate details together to get the final piece. The course is in the fundraising stage, so you only have 2 more days to get the full access to the course for only $59. So if you're interested in using modern technologies to create beautiful environment design, the affiliate link is in the description. So the situation in a big company that creates, say, a movie, is usually it has a whole lot of craftsmen and 1, maybe 2 artists. And those artists are usually called directors. It's a movie director and an art director, and maybe a few other ones. There's a whole bunch of different occupations in that regard, but all the top ones that end with the word director is pretty much our future jobs. Because what AI will be able to give us is a tool that will replace a movie production studio or a game development studio. And so today, if you're an artist that lives their life day after day, creating a little painting and posting it on the Instagram or whatever, in 10 to 15 years, we will all be standalone artists that will be posting maybe on Instagram, maybe on something else, some kind of moviegram, and every day we'll be posting a new movie, a new game, a new VR world full of realistic detail, a whole bunch of characters and storylines with a scope much bigger than what we saw in The Witcher 3 or any other game, or an insane movie like Avatar. All of that will be possible if you just have enough imagination and understanding of what you actually wanna come up with. And this is why I think the future with AI is gonna be absolutely incredible. I'm pretty sure many of you guys watching this, if you are any kind of artist, even if you're just a painter, or you make drawings, or maybe a tattoo artist, an animator, a 3D modeler, most of us, whenever we come up with some kind of stories, some kind of thing that we visualize with our, in the light of today's video, I'm gonna call it simple media, we frequently imagine things like, it would be cool to have a movie about this idea. It would be pretty cool. And that's where our thoughts have to end, because not everyone can just go ahead and, you know, start a movie production. It's pretty much impossible right now to truly make something big budget, because many ideas that artists have require production resources that are far beyond the basic movie making. But in the future, I don't think we'll have to ignore those thoughts. We will literally be able to visualize anything we want. The craft will pretty much disappear. We won't need it, but it's not bad. Everyone will become an art director. And while, again, it sounds bad that, you know, people that never studied art will be able to do the same things that artists spend so much time learning, I wouldn't worry about that either. Because today, what do we have? Literally every single human in the world has a photo camera. And it's a pretty good one these days. Is everyone a photographer? No, it's not. Why do I know that? Because whenever you stumble upon an Instagram account of an actual photographer, you immediately notice that. There is a huge difference between a work of an amateur and a professional photographer, even if you give both of them the same tools. And that difference is not going away ever, because any tool you will ever have, no matter how sophisticated it is, if you have no ideas, if you have no understanding what can actually blow people's mind today, not yesterday, but today or tomorrow, you won't be able to come up with an actual piece of art. And AI can't create new things. It can only generate many iterations of whatever was already created. And that's really good for artists, because it will remove all kinds of repetition and we'll be able to push our art to a completely unimaginable today scale. 6 months of hard work of a whole room of professionals doing this boring, repetitive work will be literally just a press of a button. So every one of those professionals that are actually just wasting their lives doing the same thing, like rotoscoping in a movie, or, you know, modeling a little bit of a different character with the same topology over and over again, just because you need 25 of them, you know, with a bit of a different shape, but there's no automatic way to do it, so you just keep doing it over and over again. I mean, right now we have AI that's pretty good at generating some kind of fusion of photos. But in the future, you'll be able to just talk to Blender and it will create a fully rigged, perfectly texturized, with a perfect topology character, and you just tell the text of what this character does and it's just done. And you just apply little tweaks to make it good. You alone will be creating huge movies in one day. And the best movie will be not the one that is, you know, done the best, but the one that actually has the best idea. And I think that's only amazing. So, will AI cause you to lose your job? Probably, but I'm certain you're not gonna miss it.